Hello and welcome to this Blender tutorial on how to use the plugin pack inside of Blender to create overlays, lower thirds for your videos. In this tutorial, we're going to be going over exactly how to use this pack of plugins, how to edit it, change the colors, the images, the logo, and the text for your content. The first thing we're going to do in Blender is click this camera icon here. This will take us to the view we get, or the view we're going to get when we render out our overlay. Now we're going to scroll down and see here our list of available lower thirds. For this example, we're going to use the like, subscribe, and hit the bell. Although inside each of these folders, there are various other folders. When you want to use one, make sure that the eye and the camera are both enabled, both for the folder it belongs to and the specific folder each of the sets is a part of. And just wait for a moment while the shaders load in. And there we have it. We can press play with this one enabled to preview what the animation is going to look like. Now, if you want to change the various colors of these, you can, and very easily. First, we're going to click on the corner here and go to Shader Editor. This will give us a single node which controls all of the functionality you require. If you see one like this in green, try not to touch it, just leave it. The only ones you need to worry about, well, it depends on what you're changing. If you want to change the colors on the subscribe, you have two sets of colors. One for the colors we see before the button is clicked, the background and the text itself. And one for after it's clicked, a different set of colors. Now you can see that the colors are completely changed and the animation still works perfectly. Again, for the bell, it's the same thing. A color for the before it's clicked, and another color for after it's clicked, giving you control over every aspect of the animations. For the cursor, it's the same story. It also comes with this strength slider, which allows it to glow. The hand can also be changed, as well as the color of this beam that comes across the screen. Now, something that's cool about this set of animations is that a lot of these textures are linked. That means if we go from this particular animation to this one, the colors we set over here still make a change over here. Same for the overlays outside of this set. Remember the red color? That's this red color here. And this kind of tan color here is the secondary color, which sets what the text will be like in these other sets of lower thirds and overlays. Now for the subscribe, liking, and bell animations, that's all the settings that are important. For you to get a range of different options and styles that you can change with a lot of ease. As I mentioned before, don't mess around with the animated properties unless you know what you're doing. The other sets of overlays and lower thirds are for displaying things such as the channel title or whatever text you require for your scene. Some of these also come with a logo. And let's get into how to change the heading text, the second text, and the logo right now. As I mentioned before, there is a main color and a secondary color which you can edit. Changing the mood of your overlays or adhering it to your personal branding colors with ease. Everything in this plugin pack is linked, so changing one thing will change it consistently with other lower thirds. For instance, if I want to change heading 1 to say Inlet animations. We can see this is also changed everywhere else in the pack. Inlet animations. Despite whatever the animation itself is, the text stays consistent. Same for heading 2. Let's say, welcome. And now if we go through the others, see it says welcome in all of them. And now for the logo, it's the same principle, except changing it is slightly more difficult, only slightly. Again, it has a strength slider if you want it to glow. But if you go over to the left here, you'll see this texture shader. Clicking on this open image button here, you'll get up an explorer for your files. And just like any other explorer, you can copy and paste in a file directory, and that'll take you to it. And here we're going to select Inlet's logo here. Just a PNG, or you can use a JPEG, but a PNG is best if you want transparency. Click, and it'll update the texture to the logo you've chosen. And every animation that includes the logo will be updated to contain the logo in it properly. So you can see here how easily textures, text, and logos can be changed to suit your requirements. The logo, the colors of your branding, of your channel, your websites, whatever it is you are wanting to use these for, you can very easily change the specifics of this plugin to suit your requirements. Now let's say you want to change the length of your animation. Make it shorter, longer, quicker, slower. This can also be easily changed. Down here, this button again. This time we're going to go to nonlinear animation. And this contains the animations that we're using to change the states of what's on screen here. And to change its length, all we have to do is select, for instance, all of the in animations and drag them to the right. And now the overlay appears for a very short time before disappearing again. You see here. If you want it to last longer, the opposite is the case. You can grab the outs and move them further to the right. And when you do this, you do have to make a change in another place. Going back to here, we have to go over to the timeline, find the point at which the animation, the lower third, has disappeared again, around here, and enter this time into the end here. That's so that Blender knows to render not only this part of the animation, but the whole thing as its video file. Now lastly, if you want it to be quicker or slower, you can select again the in or the out, or both in and out. Press F3 for a search function and type scale. Edit transform scale. It'll turn purple and you can drag it out to be wider. Now when you play, you'll see it opens up much more slowly and closes again. And now we get the whole animation in full, and it's slowed down. And the other way around, we can make it much faster. Move into the right so it's got some space. This is desynchronized because I slightly moved some of the tracks, the animation tracks. The last step, of course, is to render this. But that's nothing to be fearful of. Rendering is very easy. You just go back to the setting here and select properties. On this list of different settings down the left, you can go to the output properties, and in this box here, you can select where you want the file to render to. Create a new file. We'll also want to choose a name. For this, I'm just going to use the number 1. That's good enough. And click accept. This now has the output location listed here. Going down slightly further, you'll want to make sure that the file format is set to PNG. This is going to render out an image sequence. Now that's important because it means you can get a transparent background. And a transparent background is important, so you can put it over the top of video or use it in your stream if you're a streamer, however it needs to be used. Make sure that you have RGBA selected. The A stands for alpha. If it's just on RGB, there's not going to be an alpha channel, which is something you need. Finally, you also need to make sure that the start time and end times are set up correctly to contain the entire animation, from appearing to disappearing. Remembering to ensure that the eye and camera of your desired lower third type and the eye and camera of its parent directory are both enabled, and that no other cameras or eyes are enabled, otherwise they will also be rendered. And go up to the top left, render, render animation. You'll now see it flick through every single frame of the animation. And at the same time, in the directory you chose earlier, Blender will be rendering out image after image with a layer of transparency of the lower third as you have set it up to be. Your colors, your text, your logo. Once it's wrapped up rendering out your scene, you can watch it back in a video editor of your choice and ensure that there's no issues. If you're unhappy with the text that's been used or the colors or the logo, you can very easily go back into Blender and change these things and render it out again. Even if this seems very complicated to you at first, with a small amount of practice, you'll be conquering it in no time. Then the only step left is to put these lower thirds into whatever project or software you need them for. Practically all of these different lower thirds can be modified in this way to be faster, slower, longer, shorter. And that's really it. That's the full functionality that you have at your disposal. In just these basic settings, these simple tweaks, you can change the heading text, the second text, the main color, the second colors, the colors of the cursor, the subscribe button, the bell, the like, and the duration and speed of all of the animations, as well as your own logo. There's nothing complicated about this process. Nothing has to be modified or made new or changed within the Blender engine itself. It's all simplified and optimized for an efficient workflow, and built around the concept that even a beginner to Blender should be able to use this plugin easily for their own content. After all, if you're not a content creator who already knows Blender, there's no need that you should have to learn Blender in order to bask in the glorious benefits of what Blender and this plugin have given you.